Hello, today is the second day of summer, 2nd of June 2019, and it's a high season for strawberries. And Ulas is hunting for bugs. He loves all types of insects. But now it's just a leaf, all right. Let's go. Here's our male goat. This is the young female one. And this is our way to strawberries. This is the oldest. We've planted these strawberries when we just moved here, and they are still there. Not perfect, not too much, not too big, but they are still there. How do you preserve your strawberries? People in Ukraine usually preserve them making jam, but I don't eat sugar. I don't find it good for my body, and I don't make jam. We just freeze the strawberries and then eat them with just like they are. Today in the morning, all of the garden looked like this, so I had to de-weed it. And here are my tomatoes. They might be huge and nice. Call it the barao. And here's the place with the carrots just carrots. And it's full of weeds now. I'll let them go a bit, so I'll really see where are the carrots. And these are my cucumbers here. See all this cucumber here? It's all cucumbers, and they feel good. It's far from the permaculture, but we don't use any chemicals in our garden, and it's already the good thing. Here are the beetroots. I weed it in the morning. And this is the corn I had to take care of. This is also the line with the corn in the side of the garden. These are my tomatoes here, la la la, and I worked over with them in the morning. So here are they feel good. Feel very good, I guess. Look strong, but a lot of them died, and you see a lot of empty spaces here, and this line. They didn't survive, unfortunately. And we have already first flowers on the tomatoes. Yes, hello again. Okay. Here you can see the peas are beautiful. Here they are, more of them in this line. See? Okay. And here you can find squash, here and here and everywhere in this line. And I need to take care of this. Oh, what is the name? Pumpkins. Here are the pumpkins, sweet pumpkins. Okay, here's another Ulas with another bowl for strawberries. Дякую, синок. Зараз я трошки відпочину, та й тоді So guess what it is? Can you? It's not easy. It's a peanut. But it should be everywhere here, but it's just empty. It's only one peanut. I hope more of them are coming. There is a small one in here. Just one. I see two of them in this whole field. And I feel bad about this. Alright, I'll work a bit. And now I'm gonna show you the instrument I use. But it's hard to use it. I know. Here are my sweet peppers. Super sweet, super peppers. And sunset. And it's coming soon. I'm gonna work on pumpkins right now. Because I did some de-weeding for the squash. Now pumpkins are waiting for me. Here they are. La 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 la. And I will use this thing to make them feel good. These are, I've made the pumpkins and the squash, and here is the fields filled with peanuts that are not here right now, and I don't know if it will work with them. Then tomatoes, then cucumbers, and on that side there is some corn, more tomatoes, some sweet peppers. And one evil boy. And you can see more black parts and some gray parts in the garden. So black parts are those that I worked today, de-weeding it. And I have to tell you that I've never done so much before in one day. And it's hard, but today for some reason it was fun and nice, and I liked it. And I like the result, and I wanted to share one story with you that how it works with them. For example, these peas. First you touch it with the instrument and it's super hard, and you think, oh, it's too much peas, I will not work them till the end in 3 days, it's too hard. Then you work and work and work and work and do the first layer and say, no, I'm too tired to continue. And then I think, let me have a look what I've done. And I walk on the rows and I see, oh, there are some weeds. It can be better and better, and just work it one more time without even noticing. And then when you come on the sixth place the next day, you really, really want to touch it and to make it even more better. Yes, and it feels very interesting and can be a metaphor for any other work, and can be not. It's just the story of me and my peas and tomatoes. So it's the end of the day, and I'm standing here and thinking, I need some more work done with the corn. You see the corn here? I did this three rows right now, and these are these rows that need more work, and I kind of feel tired. Let me show you how I look. I think it's not the super perfect look for the video blog, but and my face is red for the fifth time today. But internally I feel so good. I feel that I've done something very important. Okay, I didn't show you our fish. Orest painted on the wall. He wanted something to be on the wall of the house. And it's the view from the yard, and nobody from the outside sees it. It's only for us, and it's our entrance right here. And Ross is mad. And what I didn't show you also is our cat, and she has three nice kittens, and now they are drinking milk. And it's definitely public breastfeeding, and everybody is happy about that. And this is our lemon tree. It was in blossom and smelled too strong, so I just put it right here outside, because it's very hard to sleep in the room with this tree. And this is how our table looks like in the evening. Plenty of work to do.